Segal Tractor Company in Woodville.
Picker Brothers Tractor Company in Gonzales.
Channel 9 in Baton Rouge, WAFB-TV. Newsline 9 with Phil Rainier, Brenda Braxton, weather with Edward St. Pay, and sports with Steve Snyder. This is the Newsline 9 Weekend Update.
Hello, everyone. We're glad you're with us.
Norco residents are picking up the pieces this weekend after Thursday's tragic explosion. At least six people died because of that blast at the Shell Oil refinery.
Newsline's Brian Henry traveled to Norco today and found many residents trying to pull things back together.
Rick Bradley says he's only gotten about 6 hours of sleep since Thursday's fatal explosion at the plant in Norco. Bradley says he's tired and weary from replacing shattered windows and homes and businesses damaged by the blast blocks away.
It's been real tough. It's strenuous. It drains you. We're just doing what we can to close these people up.
Six people are confirmed dead. One is still missing. Others are recovering from their injuries. 22-year veteran at the plant, John Brady, says he lost a dear friend that morning. Today, Brady says he has overcome the shock and has moved towards acceptance.
We probably never get over it. Not the idea that they died, but the idea the way they died, the impact of the explosion that happened over there is really unbelievable.
Officials say the explosion ignited in the plant's cracker room. That's where the oil is processed into gasoline. Plant Community Relations Manager Wendy Jacobs says the search for the missing worker and the cleanup has been slow.
We still have a few very small fires within the unit. They have to be allowed to burn themselves out before we can go in. We're doing what we can to continue the search for our employee.
Plant officials say this is the worst explosion ever at this Norco refinery plant. And some of the workers who lost close friends in the tragedy say Thursday will be one day they'll never forget. In Norco, Brian Henry, Newsline 9 update.